weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Shows no signs of stopping. I brought some corn for popping. Lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I'll hate going out in the storm.
I was taking some old cardstock I had lying around and I cut out my pieces. Just made an egg shape for the body and a half circle for the ear. And then I laid my body of my mouse on another piece of cardstock, traced around the nose, and then drew a straight line across, and that's his nose. So we'll put that to the side. Out of your main color, you're gonna, which is on mine, is like a tannish gray, like a tawny color. I couldn't find gray somehow. I'm just gonna cut two, because we're gonna stuff our mouse. We need two of the ears. We're not gonna stuff the ears, but we need two of the ears, two of the body, and only one of the nose, unless you're gonna make him, if you're gonna make him wear, he's double-sided, so that, you know how the ornaments get on the Christmas tree when they're just hanging there, or the kids are playing with them, they get all twisted around. If you want him to be double-sided, then cut two noses. Otherwise, just cut one. I guess we'll go ahead and make ours double-sided, though. Alright. So, I just put this on here and then cutting out around. The other way you could do it is on the wrong side of the felt, the side that's not as hairy, not as soft. You would take your Sharpie and then just trace around your pattern and cut it out that way. That might be easier for you. I should have doubled that over so I could have gotten my two pieces out at the same time. But like I said, this is a quick, fun project. Just, and you can embellish however you want to. It's just really fun. Give the kids lots of little things to use, little ribbon or just anything. Let their imaginations go wild with it. It'll be a fun project. Let's cut out our ears. You could cut these out of pinking with, not of, but with, you could cut these out with pinking shears. And the pinking shears, if you don't know what they are, this is a pinking shear. See, it has the little toothed edge here. And then when you cut, it makes a zigzag edge like that. And it turns out really cute, especially on no-sew projects or ones that you just top stitch instead of sewing the inside and turning it out and all that. You can do that and you can use pinking shears and it turns out really cute. Okay. Cut out two noses of the pink. It's a little bit harder because it's so small. Okay. And if you wanted your mouse with a more triangular nose, you know, just cut it off at a point instead of rounded like I did. This is the good thing about this project. Nobody's telling you what to do. You just be creative. Alright, now the fuzzier side of the felt is the part that you want to put out. So, on one of them, put the wrong side up, and then the other piece, put the wrong side down. For the ears, it doesn't matter, because they're going to be flipping around on the Christmas tree. Okay, so what we're going to do before we glue, we're going to take a length. I don't know, it's just several inches, it doesn't really matter. how long? As long as it will loop over your Christmas tree. There are two ways to do this. You could do it this way, like this, where his tail is just a big loop, or you could tie it like this with a smaller loop, and then it would hang like that with a smaller loop. I'm just going to double mine. For stability, if you wanted to, you could just tie the ends together really quickly so that it won't pull out. Okay, just like that. Put a little knot there. And then I'm going to put a little dot of hot glue and lay that in there like that. I'm going to use my marker so I don't burn my fingers. That's another good thing too, if you're doing this with kids, give them some kind of little stick or whatever to push it down in the glue with so they don't burn their fingers. The next step is to put the ears on. And these can go, you know, you locate them wherever you think it's cute. Just put a little dot of glue. On each side. Put his little ears in. Oh, it stuck to me, didn't it? Okay. Now, you could just do a one-sided mouse like that, and he'd be good to go. But if you're doing a two-sided one like we are, then you might want to put your nose on first. Just a little dot of glue. Stick his nose on. Turn this one over. There. Okay. Now, we have to remember we're going to stuff this mouse. So, we're not going to glue all the way around. We're going to leave a little opening right here at the top. So, we're just going to begin, I don't know, somewhere about here. Make a thin bead of glue. All the way around. Like that. But just leave an opening at the top so we can squeeze some of that stuffing in. Lay the pieces together like a little sandwich. Matching the noses. Just like that. Give it just a second to cool off and dry. Now tear off a little bit of your stuffing and push it down inside, and you stuff him just as full as you want to. He can be really fat or he can be not stuffed quite as much. That's up to you. This is your mouse. And also, you can make them as big or small as you want. If you want more of a rat size, you know, of course you're going to make your template bigger. Now see here, this is the beauty of the no-sew. If you miss a spot, you just put a dot of glue in there and squeeze them shut. Alright, once you have them stuffed sufficiently, you're going to run a bead of glue around that top edge there and do the same as before. Sandwich him shut. Be careful not to burn yourself. I already did. Ouch. Okay. Isn't he cute? The other thing that you could do is if you wanted to line the ears with pink, you could cut another smaller semicircle and put them in there. You could add wiggly eyes. But right now I'm going to show you how to do the whiskers. Okay, if you've never worked with embroidery floss before, there are 6 strands of it. So you just cut a length that, I don't know, 5 or 6 inches long. And then you're going to separate that into 2 groups of 3. So you just gently pull. There's 3, and here are 3. Oops, guess you couldn't see that. 3 and 3. Okay. Okay, take one group of three, and you're going to thread that into your needle. Okay. And then pick the spot for your whiskers. I'm going to go in right between the nose and the eyes here. And just pull that through like that. Now, your options are to leave it just like it is, but if you have small kids, they're going to pull those whiskers out in short order. So what I do is just tie a little knot there, and that'll secure the whiskers in, but it won't be terrible looking. See, you can barely see the knot. Okay, do the same thing on the other side. Thread your needle. Go in, just take a small stitch like that, pull that tail out. Okay, make your knot. Okay, and then cut them off to the length that you want. And there are your whiskers. Now, if you're doing a one-sided mouse, you only put the whiskers on one side, but if you're doing a two-sided mouse like I am, you go ahead and put them on both sides. For a little extra touch, you could put a little ribbon on. Just right there at the base of his tail. And you could even add a little jingle bell. So when the kids spin him around on the tree, he'll jingle. So there he is, your little Christmas mouse. As a variation, you could do a sewed version, where you put the two pieces together and stuff it, and then, you know, you just do a whip stitch around the outside. This one I stitched the ears and gave him little French knots for eyes. They don't show up very well. And then a felt nose. But you could sew the nose also with embroidery stitches. And on this one I made a loop tail like this and then put the bow further up. You use your imagination. And just have fun with it. This is a fun project for kids and for grown-ups.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Shows no signs of stopping.